Today we are specifically going to be talking about how to get started. What does it take to get started using Project Discovery? And what I'm going to do is I'm going to walk you through a couple of things. So first off, how do you get the Project Discovery tools? We have a lot of cybersecurity tools. We have things like Nuclei, which is our sort of our bread and butter. It's a scanning engine that lets you use YAML templates to scan for vulnerabilities in a variety of protocols. We have Katana, which is a great tool for, I'll just show you Katana later, but we have Katana, we have Nuclei, we have DNSX, we have HTTPX, we have this huge suite of tools that are all available for cybersecurity. Today's all about getting set up and making sure that you know what's going on as far as using these tools. Now I'm gonna go ahead and check and see if actually there's any update. There's anything that needs to be fixed. Okay, I feel like it should be good. Always make sure that your stuff is updated. Yep. Okay. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna do sudo. And that's gonna be install golang-go. Yes, continue. And that's gonna install go, I think it's 1.2, 1.19. You have to have at least go 1.19 in order to use PDTM, which is the tool manager we have for Project Discovery tools. One of the things that we need to double check is make sure we can see what our path is. And as you can see, here's our path. User local bin, user sbin, user bin, sbin, all this stuff, all this stuff. You'll notice that go isn't in there. And we need to make sure that the go path is installed in here so that we can actually access all the stuff we're gonna be using with go. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm actually going to find what my my path is. We're gonna pipe that into, just find where the go path is. So that's what we need. That home parallels go, we need that added to the path. So I'm just gonna go ahead and copy that, and to make sure that I actually copied it correctly, because again, all the keyboard shortcuts are different from my Mac versus this virtual machine. What I'm gonna do is I'm now going to head into, this is ZSH. I always say Zish. There's always, this is always fun. Real quick. All right, so this is my ZSHRAC file, and I need to head down to the bottom because I need to add some path stuff. So what I'm gonna do is I'm copying this from somewhere else, so I'm gonna Control Shift V that. So what we're doing is we're taking our path that already exists. We're adding this to the end because we have the path, right? We have the path variable, but we need to add this to it in order for it to know, hey, this is also part of it. And that's what's gonna make sure that you can actually call these tools later on when you're trying to call them, all right? So this says, take the variable as is, take path that we saw earlier, and just stick this at the end. Pretty, pretty please. So I'm gonna go ahead and exit out of this. I'm gonna say yes, save it. And now we need to do source. And this sort of like, as I understand it, this kind of like reboots it and says, hey, like run this to make sure that we're doing everything correctly. And once we do this, oh no, hold on, I did that incorrectly. Let's see, I must have a quote. Aha. So let's do that. That's what I needed to do. See, that's called, oops, I made a mistake on live stream. And now we're gonna fix it because pretty much a solid half of, bam. A solid half of doing work with anything, code or security or Linux, any of this stuff, is I messed up, why, and being able to look it up and find the answer. All right, let's go back to that echo path. Now we can see at the binaries, which another fun thing I learned, this bin is short for binaries and not the bin where everything goes. The binary folder is now added to the path, so it'll be able to recognize when we've installed things. Okay, next is we're gonna go to GitHub. And we're going to go to github.com/projectdiscovery. And like I said, that's our GitHub here. And this is the, let's go ahead and just make that big. This is our main page. And these are all the repos that we have where you can check out what's going on. Like I said, we're doing a PDTM here. This is our tool for managing our projects from Discovery, Project Discovery. And we're going to use this to install all of these things that you can see right here. And that's really the way we prefer y'all to install this. You can install it one at a time. If you only want one tool, like let's say, like I said, if you want just Katana, right? Which I messed up the explanation of Katana earlier. It is a, where did it go? I'm scrolling so fast. It's for crawling and spidering. That's what I was trying to say. So it can find a bunch of stuff for you by crawling and spidering the web. If you just want Katana, you can just get Katana. But if you're really looking to use all of these tools, then we really recommend using PDTM. And that's what we're going to do today. So inside here, it lets you know, hey, it needs Go 1.19 to install successfully. Run the following command. So we're going to use Go because we have installed Go 1.19. So let's copy that. And we're going to head back. We're going to min that. We're going to go here. And this is what we're going to run, right? And it's going to install it for us. Be-do-do. Let's go back here. Looks like it's all downloaded. And this is the terrifying moment of truth for me, personally. Let's make sure that it installed correctly. We can actually call PDTM. So I'm just going to call PDTM. Just going to run that. And it's not working. Okay, let me double check. Let me check my path again. Home parallels go bin. And that's where we are. And it's added to the path. I wonder if something is interfering with it. Is it that space? It's that space, isn't it? I bet. Let's see if that helps. Oh, let's do source. Need to do that first. All right, now let's run PDTM. We did it! Join the Discord.